Hi, my name is Marty Verdonk, and you're watching Marty Verdonk Master Sessions live from AAA Music, with Lex and Brian here in the studio, taking care of a great sound, as always. In this episode, we feature Frank Montes on keyboards and vocals, Chris Hoordijk on vocals, Bas van der Waal on guitar, Dave Breidenbach on bass, Mark Stope on drums, Natasha Dentoom en Sanne Groesema backing vocals. Enjoy.
Werkt wel. Ja, ik durf het niet. Want ik zat te denken, is gewoon het intro te doen als einde en dan. Dat je het intro nog een keer terugpakt. Nee.
Nee, maar van jouw druk.
Even doornemen.
Ja.
You tell me that I shouldn't be afraid. And stop wasting so much of time.
Did die eerste keer met die zinnen?
Ja.
Zing ik hem mee.
Ja.
Did you?
Bas van der Waal, Frank Montes, welcome here at the Marty Verdonk Master Sessions. Thank you so much for playing in the session. We had a great recording today.
Yeah.
And we played two of your tunes.
We did.
And Bas and you play together regularly, right?
No.
Sometimes.
Yes, lately, actually.
Yeah.
We just started a group.
Yeah.
And Bas and I, we played with Solid de Jonge, drummer, a few years ago, and I was a guest at the Fresh Cuts a couple of times in Amsterdam,
right.
Noche Jazz Club, and we always thought we should start a band,
yeah,
and we never did. So actually, a few weeks ago, we started a group,
yeah,
with me on mainly organ, no singing.
Yeah,
that's what I love most.
Yeah,
playing the organ.
There's no bass player. It's just you, Bas, and I think my wife on percussion.
Yes,
right? My
yes.
Wife. Yeah.
Yep.
So you've been playing with with a lot of bands. You're doing your own material. You toured with Gardinor.
Yes.
And Bas, you also played with Sherma Raus, yep, with Nuco Collective, Sabrina Stark, a lot of people sessions. Uh-huh. And. How are you doing now? Are there any plans for tours, albums, or do you write your own music?
I do write my own music. I've started recording an album almost 2 years ago already, mm-hmm, so I got to finish that, but some stuff came up all the time, but
yeah.
I plan on finishing that, and of course our new group, and there's always stuff going on.
Yeah,
so,
yeah. Always, yeah. When musicians trying to make an album, it always takes like years and years.
Yeah.
I know. And you, Frank?
Yes.
The same thing.
Yeah. Well, my first album took years and years.
Yeah.
Because I'm sort of a control freak, and I wanted to do everything myself.
Right.
So I think it was released in 2011.
Yeah.
7 years ago. There's still no new album. I have some songs.
But yeah.
On the other hand, I've been busy doing all sorts of stuff, making videos as well, playing organ a lot.
Yeah.
I have a great trio with Anton Goudsmit on guitar and Cyril Directie on drums.
I think you're playing on this big festival in Aruba.
Yeah, in September.
In September, cool.
Yeah.
And I know you as a Hammond player.
Yeah.
Of course, there are a lot of great Hammond players. I mean, who's your favorite? I mean, you have the old school, like the Jimmy Smiths. And
yeah, those are my influences.
Yeah.
I grew up with albums of Jimmy Smith, Jimmy McGriff, Jack McDuff,
right,
John Patton, Don Patterson, all
yeah,
those guys. But mainly Jimmy Smith and Jimmy McGriff. And my dad, the funny thing is my mom used to play. My dad didn't, but my dad bought a Hammond B3,
mm-hmm,
just because he loved the sound of it. And he bought all those albums. And his idea was to make my mom play,
right,
but my mom never did.
Ah.
And then I listened to those albums and really loved this kind of music. So then I started playing.
Yeah.
And this is what I've been doing for maybe 30 years now.
Yeah.
So it's really funny how things go.
Yeah, sure. Cool. I mean, I love the sound. I've been fortunate to play with, like Dr. Lonnie Smith.
Yeah, he's still one of the living legends.
Yeah. I did some concerts with him, and I did a tour with Steve Winwood.
Really?
So,
that's amazing.
So I love the sound. And
yeah.
I never played with Joey DeFrancesco, but I also love his sound.
Oh, yeah, Joey DeFrancesco, of course, he's a kind of his own. He's,
yeah.
He's at a level that nobody can touch.
Right.
But he's also from the Jimmy Smith school, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if he likes me saying that, but I think that's his main influence.
And
he studied with Jimmy Smith, like Tony Monaco, but yeah, he grew out to a level of his own.
Of his own, yeah.
He's on Aruba, but then an Aruba of his own.
Yeah.
he's on an island.
You have to start somewhere. I mean, I'm sure you have your idols.
Yeah, I am. When I started Well, I started playing violin actually first.
Really?
And
really?
And I went to join a band. They were like, no, man.
Not hip enough.
Pick up the guitar or something. It's like, okay. And I really started loving the guitar.
Yeah.
And then first started playing hard rock and blues and stuff. And then somehow I ended up in a fusion band. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh man, this is really cool. And then started listening to jazz. And I was like, this is what I want to do. So, And then I first heard Wes Montgomery.
Oy.
I played that shit like 30 times a day.
yeah, sure.
So, well, that's one of my...
Like Wes Montgomery, and the next step is George Benson. And then
George Benson, yeah. Oh man, he's a hero. Yeah. Graham Greene, all those guys. But also like the more modern guys like Scofield. Or I don't listen to guitar players necessarily, mm-hmm. Singers or horn players. I have my Coltrane period.
Yeah.
It's like, the closest thing to God for me.
The funny thing is that we both enjoy the same kind of music. And when you say Wes Montgomery or George Benson, those guys played with, I mean, the dynamic duo Jimmy Smith and Wes Montgomery.
Yeah, of course. I love the Hammond as well. I've played with a lot of Hammond players over the years, and just keep coming back to. I cannot play it myself. I can play a little piano, but Hammond's a totally different thing.
Right? Yeah.
So, but I like to play guitar on the Hammond.
Cool. But also, you play with Lonnie Smith. Lonnie Smith has a great album with George Benson.
Benson,
Cookbook.
Yeah, Cookbook.
It's amazing.
Yeah. Well, guys, thank you so much. It has been a privilege and a pleasure. You know, we had a great session. I mean, I love your voice, by the way. I mean, not only you're a great player,
thank you.
Really love your voice, and hopefully. Till we meet again.
Yeah. Thanks very much for having us. It was a great
session.
More
than welcome.
I've been watching all the Verdonk master sessions.
Yeah.
Since the beginning. And it's a great studio as well.
Yeah, sure. I mean, we're very fortunate to, you know, to record here, and it's so much fun to do, and every session is different, you know.
Yeah.
Has a different vibe. Of course, because we always play with a lot of different musicians, and some of you guys know each other, and some of you already play together. But especially it's a nice dynamic and a nice vibe, and
and a great opportunity to meet new musicians.
New people, of course, sure. Yeah. So, till soon.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks. Thank you guys.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Op waar zit je op 11, hè?
Ja.
Wat hangt het?
Wat wil je daar dynamisch? Want het lijkt alsof het een verlengde is van het refrein, eigenlijk het tweede refrein.
Ja.
En daarna gaat hij terug.
Ja.
Weet je welk stukje ik bedoel?
Ja. Ja, misschien dat je net even ten opzichte van het refrein ietsjes gas terugneemt, maar niet te veel.
Oké, dus het is niet zo dat het daar nog groter moet worden en dan helemaal terug.
Nee, denk het niet. Maar dan moeten we even uitproberen.
Ja.
Misschien
dat
deze galmtokken sfeer.
Ja, dat klopt.
Maar
die gaat over de zang.
Maar over
alles.
Dat de tak houdt. Ik zal. Ik neem aan dat we nog een keer doornemen of niet?
Ja.
Nou, ik zal checken, maar ik heb voor mijn horen.
safe and sound. Submit to the intoxication, 'cause when she came around, no terms of negotiation.
Chris Hordijk, welcome here at the Marty Verdonk Master Sessions. It's an honor having you here. Always, you know, great voice. I'm a big fan. People might know you, at least here in Holland, from The Voice of Holland. How long was that ago? A couple, 5-6 years ago?
Yeah, the final was January 2012, so that's quite a long time ago.
It's already a long time ago, yeah.
I almost forgot about it, so.
Okay, well, I won't mention it again. No, but how was that? How was that experience?
Well, it was a great experience. It was a whole lot of fun, and, you know, it's great to be the star of the show. You know, it wasn't all about me, but it feels like you are one of the stars.
Yeah.
And, so it was a great experience, and after that, you know, I had a few hit singles, and you know, I was quite busy. But of course, after that, it all goes down, and it gets less busy. So now I'm just trying to make music and do things that I really like, with a blues band and with some other rock songs that I'm writing with another guy.
Right. And, what is your favorite music? Is it more blues orientated?
It's really hard because people always want you to choose one thing, you know? But I really like the pop songs, like the one we're going to record today. And John Mayer style, you know?
Right.
But on the other hand, I really like Guns N' Roses and the Velvet Revolver and the Foo Fighters and all of that stuff. And blues as well. So it's really, I like a bit of too much genres. It's hard to say I do this.
Yeah. I know that I saw you in a band once and you played drums. So what was first? You played drums and then you started to sing or...
Yeah, I always wanted to be a drummer, and I started out as a drummer in the band with my sister. We had a left lane Lisa. My sister is Lisa Lois, great singer, by
great
the way.
Singer,
check her out. But I used to play the drums there, and I do some of the backing vocals. And right now, I'm in a Pearl Jam tribute band, Back Alive, and you know, I'm back to my roots. I'm just trying
drums.
And I can really go at it, you know.
So
that's great, and I sing all of the backings and one song I do lead. So,
any plans for new material, own stuff or?
Yeah, I'm currently working with Jeroen Doppen. He's a great guitarist. You know him.
Yeah,
as
I know.
Well.
Yeah, of course.
We're writing something for a new project we have. It has to be something, some of the 70s rock, bit of Black Crowes, bit of Foo Fighters. We're going to try and mash it up.
Yeah,
and that's coming along really well.
And you're doing the lead vocals.
Yeah, of course. Sure. We're doing it. It's a project from the two of us.
Okay.
because we don't want, we're trying a different approach. Mm-hmm. You know, like, I'm not comparing myself to those guys, but you know, like, you got Mick Jagger and Keith Richards, mm-hmm. you got Axl and Slash, you know, those are the two guys
combination
try to that really take charge of the project.
Right.
So we're trying to do that too. Mm-hmm. We make the choices, we do everything, and we try to form a great band around that.
Right.
So, but there's still a lot of work to do, but we're it looks good.
Well, hopefully one day when it's finished.
Yeah. Who knows?
Yeah. You know, you're always welcome.
Yeah.
Well, thanks again.
Well, thank you very much.
Good having you. And we recorded like two really great tunes, and we had a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Great band, and so. Till we meet again.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. Bye, Chris.
Thanks, man.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Probeer
het.
Is goed.
Ja,
shoot yours.
Do you hear me?
Dat was de 8e, hè?
Hey.
Was dit de 16e dan?
Ja,
zo telde ik wel.
Ja, dat is
namelijk wel.
Nee, mijn vader heeft ook.
Ja, sorry, ja, sorry. Alright.
Zo, ik denk dat ik een lekker
hè? Ik ben
vandoor,
hè?
Ja.
Dus
je
moet
out of your routine.
Natasha and Tom, Sanne Groesema, welcome here at the Marty Verdonk Master Sessions. It's your first time.
Yes, it is.
It's your second time. Yeah.
Yes.
Well, again, thank you so much. We had a great session.
Yeah, we did.
And amazing backing vocals. Did you know Chris and Frank? You know Chris, right?
Yeah.
You played in his band for a while.
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
Doing backing vocals. And did you know Frank and Chris?
Well, I knew who Frank is, and I've sang with Chris once.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Sanne, tell me a little bit about what are you doing. Is your main job backing vocals, or do you also do a lot of lead vocals? Do you have an old band? Do you have a project?
Well, I'm in the middle of a lot of things right now because I'm doing backing vocals, which I love, with different artists. And I have my own project. I write my own music.
Cool. And what kind of music?
It's electronic R&B.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, not really danceable, but kind of like mellow, and it's really sound based.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
And plans for an album, EP?
Yeah, yeah.
Working on that?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Well, Natasha?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, you were here already, and glad that you were here again.
Yeah, me too.
I mean, you're on TV all the time.
quite a lot.
Yeah, quite a lot. And I even saw you on some commercial.
Yes.
Singing.
Yes.
In the back.
Yeah.
So
lip syncing.
Yeah. I wonder, because you do a lot of backing vocals. Do you have any? You know, do you want to also do a lot of lead vocals? Any plans to be you know, in front?
Well, sometimes I am, because I'm a vocalist for the orchestra of the Royal Air Force.
That's right. Yeah.
And I work there as a backing vocalist, but also as a lead vocalist. So that's a place where I can sing lead, and with, you know, different kinds of projects and gigs, I also do lead, and I really like the mix.
Right.
When I do lead vocals, I can really tell a story, sing a whole song.
Yeah.
And when I'm a backing vocalist, I can really like function as a musician in the band, really accompany the lead singer. And I really like that too.
Well, again, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Maybe see you next time.
Yeah.
And as I always say, till we meet again.
Till we meet again.
Okay. Bye-bye. Mark Stope, Dave Breidenbach, welcome. Thank you so much for being here at the Marty Verdonk Master Sessions here at the AAA Music Studio Almere, the Netherlands.
Thank you for having us.
Dave, great bass player.
Thank you.
We've known each other for
quite a long time.
Yeah. Mark, the same thing. Tell me a little bit about what you have been doing lately. I know that we played together with a band called Tristan. And
sure.
some other projects, but you know, tell me a little bit about what are you doing.
Mainly, I sub a lot for different bass players. I can accompany some artists and some bands who are touring in the Netherlands.
Right.
And sometimes I ran into you then.
Yeah.
We meet each other there.
I saw that you're playing on a six-string bass.
Yes.
Yeah. Four wasn't enough.
Four wasn't enough. I always say I have two spares extra, but I like the sound, I get used to the sound and the neck.
The variety.
And the variety,
right.
And I can actually play different styles of music with it.
Yeah.
So, for me, it's working.
Right.
Some other people might say you only have to play on four, but I also play on four and five.
Right.
Mainly this is my bass.
Do you also play upright bass?
I also play upright,
right.
Yeah.
Is your musical background, did you went to conservatory or?
Well, I, as you may see, I'm from an Indonesian background, and they all play guitar and they all play musical. And I started out with guitar and I thought maybe I can develop myself more as a bass player,
right.
I thought, and I went for an audition at the conservatories.
Okay.
So I went there.
Right.
So I did study there.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Mark. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you're one of the top drummers here in the Netherlands. I mean, you played with a lot of people, Candy Dove, even Van Morrison, Trent Oosthuis.
Yes.
And you are, you know, people consider you like a really groove player.
Thank you.
Who are your drum influences?
It's, for me, it sounds like a cliche, but it's still like people like Steve Gadd.
Right.
He's my all-time favorite drummer because he never loses feel or groove, and that's what I really like and try to achieve in my own playing. I consider myself also a drummer who I prefer songs, always songs.
Yeah,
I'm always thinking about dynamics and what to play where, and I just love that. I don't consider myself a drummer's drummer in the way of all this technique. I just want to know.
Yeah.
I always try to play the song.
Like I always say, like music first.
Music first.
Yeah.
And so that's what I do, and I consider myself lucky that people hear that and like that.
Yeah.
And that's why I work a lot.
Work a lot. Great. Well, guys, thank you so much. It was your second time here.
Second time.
If you were one of the first episodes, you were already a guest.
Yes.
And but, happy that you were
I also wanted to share with the people that this is like really the first time I play with this guy.
Ah, okay, that's cool.
And it's
incredible.
Thanks, man. Doing great job.
No, time is
well. No, but that's one of the fun things about this program is, you know, people bringing people together that never play together or hardly play together, or maybe come from a different scene or whatever. You know, and we just have a short time to prepare the tunes and play the songs.
Sure.
And you know, you have to be really focused and sharp and try to get together. And especially like us with like the rhythm section.
Rhythm section.
Very important to get everything locked in, right? So
I think we
did
that.
But we did a great job.
I think so.
It was a great session today again. So. Hopefully, I can invite you guys for another session.
It'll be a pleasure. Yeah.
And we'll see each other anyway.
Of course. You know, so. Yeah, you know, tomorrow.
Yeah,
you know.
Tomorrow and another gig.
Thanks again, Martin, for having us.
No,
thanks,
more than welcome. Thank you so, guys so much. And
thank
till
you.
We meet again.
Till we meet again.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
De koortjes willen weten waar
ze
zitten.
Ja, dan kom ik.
Yay!
Die kan eruit, want ik sta ernaast. Ja, no pun in there.
Ja, super oké.
Waar is die plof van? Maar dat was daar. Dat was de best.
Het luistert dan best wel nauw.
Oké.
Swinging your hips, just pull me down hard. Drown me.
desire from the swing of your hips. Just pull me down hard, drown me in love. I miss the sound of your voice, the loudest thing in my head. And I ache to remember all the violent, sweet, perfect words that you said.
Well, that's it for now. Hope you enjoyed the music. Don't forget to tune in on the next episode of Marty Verdonk Master Sessions live from AAA Music. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Marty Verdonk Master Sessions. Till next time, bye bye.